Tonight we turn to this. This graphic you may have seen is doing something they want to call flattening the curve. Basically, here's what health officials want to do about coronavirus. Instead of having this big spike in cases that drops off, they want to flatten the curve and have fewer cases, maybe stretching out over a longer period of time, but certainly a more gradual rise and decline. All new tonight at 6, our Joe Bruno is explaining how canceling all these events we've told you about could help to do that.
March Madness, the NBA, the NHL, bar crawls, concerts, parades, all of these events canceled. You might be asking yourself why. It all comes back to this phrase, flatten the curve.
If we look at the trajectory of this this infection in other communities, the expectation that we are going to see escalation is real. The extent of it, we don't know.
The Panthers have keep pounding. If there was ever to be a rallying cry for us to battle COVID-19, it would be flatten the curve. Here's what it means. Doctors and scientists have come to the conclusion a whole lot of people are likely going to get COVID-19. The goal now is to make sure the hospital system isn't overburdened.
The overall number of infections is much less of a worry than how many of these infections occur at once.
Take a look at this graph. On the x-axis here, you have the time since the first case. On the y-axis, you have the number of daily cases. The healthcare system capacity is right here. Without protective measures in place, we could see cases soar, creating this huge spike. All of these coronavirus patients combined with people who need other treatments bogging down a healthcare system. The goal is to stop that spread, but until that happens, the next best thing is to slow it down. By canceling all of these events and practicing social distancing, it helps flatten the curve, spreading out COVID-19 cases, easing the burden of doctors, hospitals, and medical professionals.
That's all we can do at this point is continue to try to contain.
All of these cancellations and postponements are aimed to flatten the curve and prevent situations like what is happening right now in Italy, where doctors are overwhelmed, hospitals are overflowing, and people are on lockdown.
And Joe, we also know you talked to the Mecklenburg County health officials, asking them why Mecklenburg County is only receiving 3 tests at a time for coronavirus.
This is just stunning to me. We are the state's largest county, and we only have access to 3 tests at a time. 3. How is that okay? I had to ask.
JB, clarification, are you only getting 3 tests at a time from the state right now?
Yes.
How is that acceptable?
That's a good question. It is what they have available to give to us. They have 100 counties, and they're sending tests out across all of the counties at this point.
Why is that? I mean, whose fault is this? How is it that we're in the United States right now and we don't have enough supplies to test people in the midst of this pandemic?
That's not something that I can answer. We've seen mixed messages around testing, and we also know that the supply is just limited. So we're doing the best we can. We're working with Atrium, who has some capacity to test, and we're continuing to work with LabCorp, who has some capacity to test. But everybody's a bit limited at this point. Unfortunately, in this country, we're behind with our ability to test.
Yeah. I asked the health director how many tests she needs. She told me significantly more than 3. One more important detail, though. These are the tests offered by the county health department. Hospital and medical groups are also offering limited testing.
Sounds like they may be demanding, but their hands might be tied at this point.
Enough tests for the number of people at this desk right now. All they have.